broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight. O'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming. In the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the home of the brave?
Thank you. And now for your starting lineups. Starting for the Yellow Jackets. At setter, sophomore number 2, Cody Rogan. At middle blocker, sophomore number 7, Philip Van Essendel.
We welcome you back to the
at setter, senior
Arena,
number
Vista, Virginia,
8,
for this edition of Night's broadcast.
At middle blocker,
contest
freshman
of
number
NCAA
10,
Division
Nick 3 Fortrell.
Men's volleyball, a conference class
hitter,
in the CBC,
11,
featuring
Matthew
your
Carroll.
Number 1 ranked team in the country,
at outside
Southern
hitter,
Virginia
sophomore
University,
number 12, Ian
against the visiting Randolph-Macon
Yellow
Jackets.
Freshman,
my name is Quentin Meyer, and I'll be bringing
Plucker.
The action today. Along with our stellar production crew at Knights Broadcasting. The Knights, of course, here sporting their home grays and the Randolph-Macon Yellow Jackets in their home blacks as we get the starting lineups read off here.
And now starting for your Knights.
Today's the last regular season matchup for both teams. Of course, this matchup also does not have any implications in the conference standings as the conference tournament matchups are all set. Randolph-Macon clinching the fourth seed. Next week is the start of the Continental Volleyball Conference Tournament. The quarterfinals, Randolph-Macon will be hosting Eastern Illinois on Tuesday, April 9th, in the first quarterfinal game, the number 4 and 5 seed matchups. And of course, Southern Virginia, not only are they number 1 team in the country, but more importantly, they clinched the number 1 seed earlier this week in the CBC to host the conference tournaments and get that first round bye along with Juniata College. The Knights and Yellow Jackets faced off once earlier this season. The Knights, of course, sweeping that one 3-0 en route to their very quick start to the season. That continues to be impressive. They're a perfect 25-0 on the season, 8-0 in conference play. The Knights are 10-1 all time against the Yellow Jackets, their only loss coming last season in a 3-set sweep. And while, again, this matchup doesn't have any implications on the conference standings, Randolph-Macon, a team that in recent memory has given the Knights some fits. Last year I mentioned the Yellow Jackets managed to sweep Southern Virginia on their home court in Ashland, Virginia, 3-0. The Knights were able to take the second matchup of that season 3-2, having to come back from 2-0 down. So we should be in for a very competitive matchup, a tune-up for next week's CVC tournament. And Knights will just need to ride the wave of momentum that they've gained throughout this season, also having earned that number one ranking nationally in the AVCA earlier this week. But coming off of a 3-set sweep against Marymount, the number 20 team in the country. So if there's any doubt that the Knights have earned that number one ranking, you can put that away.
Can you turn your mic up a little bit?
Randolph-Macon coming into today's matchup with an 18-9 mark on the season overall, 5-3. In conference play. As both teams are getting set back out to the floor for the beginning of set number 1. Knights are starting with their their typical starting lineup now, including Jeremy Brown, Sam Canlin, Tyler Schaefer, the setter Kyler Evans as well, Christian Schaefer, returning All-American, as well as the libero Justin Madsen, who leads the team in digs this year. Randolph Macon able to counter with a pretty formidable lineup themselves. This is Jeremy Brown on the serve to get us going in set number one today. Clean serves and a good receive. They're going to set up on the far side, rejected by Kyler Evans and Tyler Schaefer again to Cody Rogan. That's going to be outside, and the first point today is for Southern Virginia. Cody Rogan, 212 kills at second on the team coming into the day for the Yellow Jackets. He's going to go back at it just outside that top left corner. Jeremy Brown sprawls. But the Knights were safe there. A 2-0 lead early on. This is Jeremy Brown, another service, and that one's into the net. A service error. Very typical of the Knights as they do have quite a few service errors in each matchup, but they've been able to counter that this year with lots of service aces. Jeremy Brown, one of those guys leading the team in that category. Tough pass from Justin Madsen, but good recovery by Christian Schaefer. And the Yellow Jackets back on the attack with Cody Rogan. That's rejected. Or I believe it just went straight out. So that'll be a third point for the Knights to get back up by two. Just Jaron Brown, brother of Jeremy Brown, back to serve. It's a high serve, nicely received. The Yellow Jackets on the attack, rejected by Christian Schaefer. Jaron Brown again. Good set there for Cody Rogan. Again rejected. Christian Schaefer on a roll defensively to start this one. That's a 4-point lead now for Southern Virginia at 5-1 as Jaron Brown again still back to serve. Powerful serve. It was a good recovery by the Yellow Jackets, with the Knights back on the attack with Christian Schaefer off the front line. Good dig there. Cody Rogan again. Kristen Bianking and Christian Schaefer got to it, but it sailed out of bounds. Jeremy Brown made a bid for it, but that'll be a much needed point for Randolph Macon. Crystal Bianking leads the team in blocks with 67 on the year. He's been a big handful for their opponents this season. He's going to be set up by Tyler Schaefer. Quick kill for Cristo.
Serving for the Knights, number 10, Tyler Schaefer.
Tyler Schaefer now back to serve. Cristo Bianking has been used more for his defensive specialties, but still can certainly get in on the attack. There's a nice looking kill. That was number 7, Phil Van Ezedelft. Randolph Macon visited Buena Vista earlier this season. Van Ezedelft seemed to be their most productive player on the attack, leading them their team in kills, I believe, in that one. It was a tough receive from Justin Madsen. There's a service ace for Randolph Macon to get themselves back in it. The count is now just 6-4. Cody Rogan on the serve, sophomore from Chesapeake, Virginia, and two straight service aces for Rogan. That one's gonna sail past the line out of bounds. So a service error for Rogan to counter those two aces. Christian Schaefer again on the serve. Again, the returning All-American. It's a clean pass. Rogan gonna set up his teammate Van Ezendel for another kill. Cody Rogan, that unique ability to be a playmaker as well as a big hitter for them. There's this Cristo Bianchi. Nice recovery by Sam Cantlin and Tyler Schaefer. Softly over. Yellow Jackets on the attack. Van Esendelft again. Philip Van Esendelft single-handedly bringing his team back even with Southern Virginia knotted at seven early in set one. That's going to stay in. Justin Madsen had a good look at it. He figured it would go out, but it stays just inside that line. A third service ace. That time it was Matthew Carroll who's back up to bat again. Tyler Schaefer setting up Sam Cantlin. A nice looking dig, but it goes off the ceiling and back over, so that'll be a point for Southern Virginia to hopefully get some momentum back in their favor. This is Bianchi back to serve. Clean service off the ceiling. Tough handle for Cody Rogan. Softly over as Kyler Evans and Tyler Schaefer were in midair and couldn't get back down to dig that one out. Good looking start for Randolph-Macon. It looks similar to how things would be in their first matchup when Southern Virginia went out 5-1 early on, but they've responded well. This is Sam Cantlin, lots of power. Off the ceiling, a tough bounce for the Yellow Jackets. And the Knights get one back. That'll be Sam Canlin's first kill in the day. He was very important in their win against Randolph-Macon earlier this season. Very amped up as he knew how tough an opponent Randolph-Macon was to the Knights last season. That time into the net, another service error. The Yellow Jackets will have Cade Terrell back to serve, the senior setter from Glen Allen, Virginia. Easy receive for Tyler Schaefer. This is Jeremy Brown, the kill.
Kill by Jeremy Brown.
Maybe miscommunication there from the Yellow Jackets. Knights back in the attack with the Schaefer special, and that's going to be a net fault, I believe. Point in favor of Randolph-Macon. We always mention the names Jeremy Brown and Tyler Schaefer, part of that just loaded junior class for Southern Virginia. Obviously still more years of eligibility left. Tyler Schaefer's gonna set up Kyler Evans. Knights get one back again to knot things at 11. But so far Randolph-Macon has had the response. As we go back and forth here in the middle of set one. Jaron Brown had a couple of nice serves early on, another good looking one. That time rejected. Christian Schaefer and Cristo Bianchi combining. Bianchi and another one of those juniors. Another good looking serve right to Christian Schaefer. Puts it back down. Another point for Southern Virginia to extend that lead to two. Give themselves just a little bit of breathing room, and that forces Randolph-Macon into a timeout from head coach Christian Taylor. So after a quick start from Southern Virginia in the first set, Randolph-Macon was able to respond, but a good couple of moments for Christian Schaefer, combining on that block with Krista Bianchi to get the Knights back to lead. And then a soft set from Randolph-Macon turned into a point back the other way for Schaefer again. Knights lead at 13-1, six kills for Southern Virginia, five for Randolph-Macon, but six attack errors so far for Randolph-Macon. That was in the early going, have been the story so far. Randolph-Macon seems to have been able to counter that with three service aces. No aces yet for Southern Virginia. A at Marymount in the going back to the CBC tournament. Marymount was able to clinch that 3 seed, I believe. They'll face off against Rutgers Newark. And of course, Randolph-Macon and Eastern Mennonite, the number 4 and 5 seed. So this could be a preview to the semifinal matchup in the CBC tournament. Southern Virginia, the number 1 seed, will face off against the winner of the 4 and 5 seed game. And then Juniata, the 2 seed, will face off against the winner of Marymount or Rutgers Newark. This is Jaron Brown back to serve. Lots of power. It's going to go outside the line. Another service error for Southern Virginia. Gives the Yellow Jackets another point. Nick Futrell on the serve. Now there's Schaefer able to get there before Matthew Carroll. And then Cristio Bianchi puts it straight down. Another kill for him. Tough break for Matthew Carroll of the Yellow Jackets. Almost able to get to that one before Tyler Schaefer. Another rejection from Christian that time. As the middle blockers for Southern Virginia trying to find a groove, and they are finding it. 15-12, the advantage for Southern Virginia. This is Tyler Schaefer. Nicely received. On the attack goes Cody Rogan just outside. Tried to push that one over Christian Schaefer and Krista Bianchi, none doing. Knights starting to find their groove again, and it's not from their attack, surprisingly. It's on the defensive side of things. Another good, powerful serve from Tyler Schaefer. That's going to give the Yellow Jackets trouble. Good dig by Justin Madsen. This is Sam Cameron straight down.
Number 9, Sam Cameron.
Sam Cameron's one of those couple of guys in the Knights roster that year that recently returned from a church mission for 2 years, so he wasn't part of the group last year or the year before. He was on their conference championship team in 2021 and has gotten more and more playing time this year and has been pivotal in the Knights' attack. Good recovery from the Yellow Jackets, but one too many hits. And that'll be another point for Southern Virginia as they are on a tear right now. Timeout, Randolph-Macon. Momentum has certainly shifted a couple of times here in the first set. It was in favor of Southern Virginia in early going when they grabbed a 5-1 lead. Randolph-Macon fought back to take an 11-10 lead at one point. But since then, Southern Virginia has gone on an 8-1 run to open things up. And also an announcement that River Crossing Apartments will be hosting our intermission fan contest. Fans have the opportunity to win this flat screen TV here behind the scorers table. So thanks to Russ Tompkins and his River Crossing Apartments crew for that, sponsoring this wonderful event. Contestants will be drawn from a raffle in between the first and second sets. The actual contest will take place between the second and third sets. And of course, Knights Athletics is very appreciative of all of our sponsors, and we'll make sure to give them all shout outs between each set. This is Tyler Schaefer getting back to serve. 18-12 the advantage for Southern Virginia as they have snatched the momentum back from Randolph-Macon here towards the end of the first set. Knights have only lost 3 sets all season. 2 of those were to Rutgers Newark, who gave the Knights a bit of a scare last week. Then the third one was against Juniata. Tough handle for Matthew Carroll. Certainly not getting any assistance from the barn. As these powerful serves from the Knights have been giving Randolph-Macon difficulty in the first set here. Tyler again, just inside. Another service eight for Schaefer. As the libero Brady Plucker. Seemed pretty positive that that one went out of bounds, but the official thought otherwise. And that's 20 on the board for Southern Virginia. Inside again, Tyler Schaefer finding that sweet spot in the formation of Randolph-Macon. Make it three consecutive service aces, 21-12 the score. I believe those are the first three service aces on the day for the Knights as Tyler Schaefer sends that one out of bounds. He'll follow up those aces with a service error. But we'll certainly take the 3-for-1 on that. This is Cody Rogan off the top of the net. Good set from Tyler Schaefer to his brother Christian. Good dig by the Yellow Jackets. This is Bianchi again, just inside. Another kill for Criso. He's been on fire defensively and on the attack.
Serving for the Knights, number 11,
that one was right in his wheelhouse that time. As we'll have Christian Schaefer back to serve this time. Knights 3 points away from clinching that first set. There's a good receive from the libero Plucker. Good dig from Tyler Schaefer. Christian Schaefer flies in just outside.
Point, Yellow Jackets.
That one's a little low and barely made it over the net. Out of bounds. Point back to Randolph-Macon. Says Cade Terrell. Tougher seed for Madsen, but it turns into another kill for Christo Bianchi. I believe that's four kills to his name up to this point. He'll be back to serve, 23-14. High riser, it's a good serve. Good receive from Plucker. Off the hands of Jeremy Brown, that's a kill for Randolph-Macon as it went to the court before. I think that was Christian Schaefer in the vicinity before any Knights could get to it. This is Matteo DeLuca. Tyler Schaefer setting up Kyler Evans. Didn't get over top of it like he wanted to. There's a rejection. Or no, it went on the other side of the net. My mistake. As Kyler Evans was kind of blocking that angle from the scorer's table. Two consecutive kills for Randolph-Macon. Sam Canlin straight down. He'll take one right back for set points. That'll be three kills for Sam Canlin. He also has half a block to his name right now. Nice looking serve. Cody Rogan gonna set up his teammate in the middle, Nick Futrell.
Point, Yellow Jackets.
A freshman middle blocker getting on the board. It was a nice speed from Cody Rogan when it was tough to handle off of that serve. Cade Terrell. He'll float that one over the Knights. Tyler Schaefer, nifty, puts it right down in front of Futrell. And that'll do it for set number one. Knights take it 25-17. But it was competitive indeed as Randolph-Macon held an 11-10 lead at one point, but the Knights snatched back momentum to take set number one. And as we head into just a couple of minute break here, the Knights Athletic Department again wants to thank all of our many sponsors for their continued support in Knights Athletics, those being River Crossing Apartments, Straws, Drinks and Eats, Cornerstone Bank, Papa John's locally owned and operated, Vinyl Cuts, Katana Sushi and Hibachi Express, The Beeve, and Grace Automotive, who also offer 10% discounts to students and staff of Southern Virginia. So just as they show their support for Knights Athletics, we ask all of you tuning in to show your support for these local businesses as well. As we'll let you all focus in on the drawing for the contest will happen between sets 2 and 3.
Participant number 1, check your number for 565733. Participant number 2, 565730. And participant number 3, 565752.
We're getting those raffle numbers read off again. This is sponsored by River Crossing Apartments.
Thank you.
We appreciate very much their support in our night's athletics. We'll have all these winners compete in between the second and third sets. Again, a chance to win this flat screen TV that's being held behind the scorer's table. But before that happens, we have a set number 2 to get to here in just a minute and a half. Knights were able to dominate that first set for the majority of play. 12 kills compared to Randolph-Macon's 8. Randolph-Macon had 8 attacking errors. That is mostly what led to their defeat there in the first set. Knights boasting a 500 hitting percentage, as well as those 3 service aces from Tyler Schaefer to blow open that first set after being down 11-10. Rattled off 8 of the next 9 points to put themselves up 18-12 in that situation. But again, the Southern Virginia group is just loaded, especially that junior class. Jeremy Brown, Christian Schaefer, Kyler Evans, Christo Bianchi, just to name a few. But everybody on this roster has been very valuable throughout the season. Tons of athleticism, tons of skill, tons of power in this lineup, which has led to their regular season crown for the 2nd consecutive year. Of course, the Knights hosted last year's CBC tournament at Washington and Lee. They unfortunately lost in the first round in the semifinal to Rutgers Newark in 5 sets, almost pulled off a remarkable comeback. But of course, the Knights are looking for payback this time around in the very powerful Continental Volleyball Conference, comprised of some of the best teams in the country, as we head back out for set number 2. Cody Roken back to serve once again for Randolph-Macon. He's been heavily involved. Obviously, he's a setter, also on the attack. Has a couple of kills to his name as well. Nice looking serve. That time was a tough handle for Sam Canlin. That allows Randolph-Macon on the attack. Rejected. Diving for it was Plucker, cannot get to it in time, and the Knights open up the second set with a point. That was Bryce Matthews, the outside hitter, a freshman from Chesterfield, Virginia, going after that one. Again, just proves how difficult it is to get through those blockers of Southern Virginia. That one's just outside from Jaron Brown. Randolph-Macon able to tie this one back up. But as good as Randolph-Macon has been in the past, they've enjoyed an even better this season this year. 18-9, the overall mark. 5-3 in the difficult CBC. Block that time, but it goes out of bounds. It was Ian Wagenhauser, the outside hitter, getting a hand of that one. Brady Plucker wasn't able to turn the corner in time. And that'll be point number 2 of the set for Southern Virginia in a 2-1 lead. That was Ian Wagenhauser meeting Tyler Schaefer at the net. They're going to rule that point in favor of Southern Virginia. Wagenhauser trying to protest, as well as head coach Christian Taylor. But they're going to say Wagenhauser interfered that time with Schaefer. And he'll be back to serve. 3-1 lead now for the Knights. That one goes into the net. Fifth service error on the day for Southern Virginia. This is Matteo DeLuca, I believe, heading back for the service. Easy to handle for Jeremy Brown. They're going to go to Sam Canlin, softly over. Now Bryce Matthews, as it goes off the ceiling, has to softly put it back over. Christian Schaefer straight down. Again, the barn coming into play just a little bit there as Bryce Matthews points to the ceiling as he interacts with head coach Christian Taylor. Just a tough break that time for the Yellow Jackets. Cody Rogan again going to set up Matthews, a rejection back into the face of Matthews. Looks to be okay, but another block for Southern Virginia as Jeremy Brown and Krista Bianchi on that far side. Able to get all the contact on that one. 5-2 the score for Southern Virginia. It is Schaefer, Christian into the net that time. As the service errors starting to pile up a little bit here in the second set. That's 6 now on the day for the Knights. There's Schaefer setting up Krista Bianchi. Nice dig that time from Kate Terrell. This time it's Brown off the hands of DeLuca. Another kill for Jeremy Brown. He's second on the team entering this contest behind Christian Schaefer. As on pretty much any program, you can name it, in the country, Jeremy Brown could be a number one hitter. Just shows how loaded the Southern Virginia roster again is. Another rejection that time. Jeremy Brown got all of it. Yellow Jackets not able to recover that time. The lead's now 7-3. As the Knights are looking to put away this set pretty early on. But this is around the time when Randolph-Macon managed to make that first set competitive and vault themselves into the lead. Nice dig there from Tyler Schaefer. Sam Canlin just outside. Much needed point for Randolph-Macon. Sam Canlin, again, has been very involved in the Knights' attack so far. As the season's gone on, he's gotten more and more playing time and has been valuable in the Knights' attack. Off the hands that time of Nick Futrell. Just in between, I believe, Wagenhauser and I think it was DeLuca over there on the far side. Both sprawled for it, but couldn't get to it in time. It's Sam Canlin back to serve now. Nice looking serve again from Canlin. Brady Plucker dived for it, couldn't get there in time, and it floats out of bounds towards the scorer's table. Mark that down as another service ace. That time into the net. And Sam Canlin not happy with that attempt. That's the, I believe, second service error for him on the day. Quickly back to it is Tyler Schaefer and Kyler Evans. A miscommunication. Randolph-Macon back to it. A good dig from Christian Schaefer. He gets it back. And back and forth we go. That's going to go off the ceiling back over. So that'll be a point for Southern Virginia. Good effort there that time from Nick Futrell. But again, the barn not doing any favors for Randolph-Macon. Again, off the ceiling it goes for Randolph-Macon on that service. Those powerful serves are proving difficult for the Yellow Jackets to handle as they're able to receive it well, but it continues going off the ceiling. This is Wagenhauser having to put it over. Rejected that time. Good dig by Madsen. Putting it back over and inside for Southern Virginia. Timeout from Christian Taylor of Randolph-Macon. It's 12-5 now, the score in set number two for Southern Virginia.
Timeout, Randolph-Macon.
And you can tell the Yellow Jackets are getting pretty frustrated with those services. They're receiving it nicely, but of course the low ceiling here at the Knights Sports Arena is making it difficult for them to get it to their setter and ultimately go on the attack. Knights, of course, taking advantage of it as their serves have been a lot to handle for Randolph-Macon. As well as their leading attacker, Ian Wagenhauser, has been kept in check for most of the afternoon. He led the team coming into today with, I believe, 274 kills to his name. Played in 25 matches and, of course, started all 25 of those. I think Cody Rogan's been done a pretty good job so far. Been very consistent. Rogan, the sophomore setter from Chesapeake, Virginia.
Number four, Jeremy Brown.
It'll be Jeremy Brown back to serve. We'll see how Randolph-Macon comes out of that timeout. Another good serve. Randolph-Macon able to handle it that time, but Cody Rogan too soft and off his side of the net. Another point for Southern Virginia, so mark down another attacking error for Randolph-Macon. Powerful serve off the hands of Wagenhauser. Knights are bringing the heat on these serves. Jeremy Brown again, nicely received that time from Plucker. Looking to go straight down, was it Van Esendelt? That point will go in favor of Southern Virginia, I believe a net fault potentially from Randolph-Macon. Jeremy Brown again, that time outside. Good read from Matthew Carroll to let that one go. We'll see Bryce Matthews come back in for Randolph-Macon, standing at 6'9". He's a load to handle, but the blockers of Southern Virginia have been doing a good job so far. This is Kyler Evans straight down again. Another kill for Evans.
18, Kyler Evans. Back to serve for the Knights. Number 8, Jaron Brown.
Jaron Brown coming back in for the serve. Nice play by Plucker to recover. Bryce Matthews goes to the far side. Knights having trouble getting set up, and Randolph-Macon on the attack. This is Van Esendelt. Dug out by Canlin. Straight down again, Christian Schaefer. It was a good dig by Plucker on that service, but seemed to leave the Yellow Jackets scrambling and gave Christian Schaefer an open area on the floor for that most recent kill, but that service error will fly way out of bounds. And this will be Matthew Carroll, freshman outside hitter for the Yellow Jackets. Cristo Bianchi, four early kills in that first set. Good recovery from Randolph-Macon, just outside though from Wagenhauser. And that'll be an 18-7 lead for the Knights. That's gonna go off the ceiling. back over the net. That'll be a point for Randolph-Macon. That's the third or fourth time that Randolph-Macon has received one or dug one that's gone off the ceiling and back over, of course. That ends the point. This is Rogan setting up Matthews. Good recovery. Wagenhauser deflects that back down. Now Esendelft. Good net play from Randolph-Macon. Straight down, though, for Christian Schaefer. Knight able to find that magic number of 21st again here in set number two. As Tyler Schaefer is back to serve. There's Plucker for Wagenhauser. Now Matthews off the ceiling again. Christo Bianchi straight down.
Now look by number one, Christo Bianchi.
Tough communication again. As that ball comes straight to the commentating table that time. But again, you can see that Randolph-Macon, of course, is just, you know, as most teams that come here into the barn, not used to playing with that low ceiling as their sets are going. What would be typical for a higher ceiling, they're going off the roof here in the Knight Sports Arena and coming back down awkwardly, making it tough to handle. That one off the top of the net. Good recovery from Wagenhauser. Then Van Elsendelft able to reject Christo Bianchi at the net. Straight down, Sam Canlin. One more kill to his name. It has been all Southern Virginia here in set number two. Christian Taylor going to take Ian Wagenhauser out here in the late stages of the second set, looking to get him re-energized for set number three potentially. Another rejection that time from Christian Schaefer. Off the ceiling it goes. Tyler Schaefer feeding Bianchi, rejected Van Esendelft. DeLuca back to serve. Knights 1 point away from set point. This is Bianchi with another kill.
Boy, nice.
Set point. Knights on the verge of going up two sets to none. It's Christian Schaefer back to serve, the All-American. High flyer. Handled well from DeLuca, rejected inside. Just what the Yellow Jackets needed. That's Mitchell Wyatt, the junior outside hitter from Prince George, Virginia. Good moment for him, as this is Davis Luck back to serve. Jeremy Brown down there, another kill, and that'll do it for set number two. Jeremy Brown able to counter with one of his own. That'll lead us into the short break in between sets number two and three. And before we get to some more analysis and breakdown of today's contest, we'll have the intermission competition between our winners that were selected in between sets one and two. Again, this is being hosted by River Crossing Apartments. We thank them for their support of Knights Athletics. As we have one of our athletic directors, assistant athletic directors, Logan Davis, is directing traffic. And before we get back to set number three, we will let you all tune in and enjoy the intermission festivities.
Today, so we're gonna have three contestants. on this side. You guys can spread out throughout the line. All you have to do is serve in that direction and hit one of the shirts. The first one to hit a shirt wins a brand new TV thanks to River Crossing Apartments. Let's go, Annalise. You go first in 3, 2, 1, go. Oh, go Smith. Go Smith. Oh, Abby, pressure's on. Oh, Annalise, it's your turn. I told her my name, said it's nice to meet you. Then she handed me a bottle of water with tequila. I already know she's a keeper. Just from this one. Too long, Abby. Don't miss. No, no, no. Smith, it's your turn, buddy. Abby. Abby, press your song. Come on. Annalise, it's all yours. Smith. Wow. Not even close. Abby, you sure you played volleyball? Is winning. Oh, we got our winner, Smith. Good job, everybody. Good job, Annalise. Good job, Abby. Smith, congratulations. You win a brand new TV thanks to River Crossing Apartments. Fans, if any of you are interested in housing for next school year,
and we're back here at Knights Broadcasting. We hope you enjoyed.
He is the owner of River Crossing Apartments.
Intermission game there between sets 2 and 3. As you can see, there was a contest between three Knights fans. We could put a service on top of one of the three t-shirts on the far side of the court. So congratulations to the winner of that. And as we head towards the third set of this one, Knights lead it 2-0. Before we get to a little bit more game breakdown, again, the Knights Athletic Department wants to thank our very many sponsors for their continued support of Knights Athletics. Those sponsors, of course, being River Crossing Apartments, who sponsored that last event, and then Straws Drinks Neats, Cornerstone Bank, Papa John's, locally owned and operated, Vinyl Cuts, Mill Creek Orthodontics, Katana Sushi and Hibachi Express, The Beeve, and Grace Automotive, who offer 10% discounts for students and staff of Southern Virginia. So for the side of Randolph-Macon, again, it's been Philip Van Esendelf, the sophomore middle blocker, who is leading the way in terms of production on the attack. 4 kills for him out of 9 total attacks. And then for the Knights, they have a plethora of athletes who have been on the attack and doing so very well. It's Christo Bianchi leading them with 6, or rather Christian Schaefer with 7 kills, but then Sam Canlin and Christo Bianchi with 6 kills apiece. Not only is this an important matchup for Southern Virginia to keep that momentum going into the postseason with the CVC tournament and, of course, the NCAA tournament following that. Randolph-Macon will look to do the same as they'll face off against Eastern Mennonite in the quarterfinals of the CVC tournament. They'll host that on their home court in Ashland, Virginia. That'll be a matchup of the number 4 and 5 seeds, and the winner of that matchup will play the number 1 seed, Southern Virginia, next weekend here in the Rockbridge County area. Stay tuned for where that will be hosted. Last year, the Knights were the hosts of the tournament, but unfortunately lost in the semifinal to Rutgers Newark, 3-2. Knights, of course, looking for quite a bit of a different outcome this time around. Jeremy Brown back to serve. Get us going in set number three. Cody Rogan going to set up Wagenhauser. Off the block, it's out of bounds. A good start for Wagenhauser, who was visibly frustrated with so many digs and so many passes going off the ceiling here at the Knights Sports Arena. Good start for him. And there seemed to be a bit of a miscommunication between the side of the Knights and the officials. I think they're going to redo the point. Maybe the signal wasn't given to go ahead with the serve. It'll still be Cody Rogan back there. 1-0 the score here in set number three. Good pass from Justin Mattson. They're going to set up Kyler Evans. That time almost seemed to get help from the barn. But of course that was not anticipated by, I believe, Bryce Matthews. And that'll be the first point for Southern Virginia in the set of kill for Kyler Evans. This is Jaron Brown off the top of the net. Plucker's going to feed Matthews. Dug out by Schaefer and out of bounds, though. For another important point for Randolph-Macon. They really struggled to get out of the gates, to get out of the gate in the second set and never really recovered. So a very promising start for them in the third. Miss Bianchi just outside. It was very close. No, it will be awarded. After both officials consulted, that'll be a kill for Bianchi to tie things up at two. Tyler Schaefer off the top of the net. Another service error. As we'll see Matteo DeLuca, as well as Nick Futrell come in for Randolph-Macon. Miscommunication, Madsen and Jimmy Brown. Good recovery from Sam Canlin, but it's gonna go just out. Randolph-Macon now a 4-2 lead. You could hear head coach Tom Peterson yelling the boys to get going. It's been of a sluggish start here in the third set. Schaefer gonna feed his brother inside. That's Christian on the kill to get the Knights within one. Schaefer special that time. The senior Tyler to his younger brother Christian. There's Christian off the top of the net, nicely handled by Plucker, rejected by Bianchi at the net. A fault there from Nick Futrell, point in favor of Southern Virginia.
Serving for the nine, number 11, Christian Schaefer.
Christian just outside.
Point, Yellow Jackets.
Much needed point for the Yellow Jackets to reclaim that lead at 5-4. Easily there for Jeremy Brown. Christian Schaefer soars in. Plenty of opportunities through the season to get a snapshot of that one in and frame it wherever you want. So often Christian Schaefer comes soaring down the middle, and more often than not, it results in something good for Southern Virginia. Christo Bianchi into the net for a service error. As again, a bit of a sluggish start for the Knights here in the third set. That'll be just outside. So Randolph-Macon counters the Bianchi service error with an error of their own.
Sam Canlin.
See Nick Futrell coming back in for the Yellow Jackets. Nicely received by Wiggenhouse. They're going to set up Cody Rogan on the far side. That'll be just out of bounds. Or my mistake, that was Matthew Carroll, the outside hitter. Boy, can he elevate. Camlin back to serve. He has 6 kills today. Good recovery from Carroll to keep it alive. This is Kyler Evans rejected inside. Nicely done from Nick Futrell again. Get the sense that we are in for a competitive and potentially lengthy third set. This is Jeremy Brown, a little off balance. Inside it goes. He's laughing at that one, says he knew. He didn't have a great angle and was off balance, but finds a way. That's what the great hitters do. Put another kill to the name of Jeremy Brown. But then he puts that one just outside. So the Knights haven't really been able to find their rhythm. They've had several big kills here in the early going, but continued to counter them with service errors to keep Randolph-Macon in it. Tyler Schaefer setting up Kyler Evans. A kill right into the chest of Brady Plucker. Flies out of bounds as he'll come to the bench as Jaron Brown comes back in. Nicely received, Van Hesendelft, straight down in between the Brown brothers, Jaron and Jeremy. Van Hesendelft, one of the few bright spots for the Yellow Jackets in that second set, picking up where he left off. This is Christian, just outside. Good challenge from Van Hesendelft, forcing Christian to the outside on this near side in front of the scorer's table. Matthew Carroll on the serve. Krista Bianchi certainly did not get all of that on that one, but it works out in their favor as Randolph-Macon had a tough time getting to it. Bobbled around on their own side, and ultimately another point for Southern Virginia. It is 10-9 the score, or 10-9, correct. As that one's going to deflect off that front line of Southern Virginia. It's now 10-9 in favor of Randolph-Macon. And Canlin, nice dig that time from DeLuca. Far side, Wagenhauser just outside, big time block. But it floats just out of bounds. Point back to Randolph-Macon. This is DeLuca. They're going to set up a Christian Schaefer. Deflects off of Wagenhauser. Out of bounds again. Another kill for Christian. Coach Tom Peterson encouraging his squad to get back in front here. They've been trailing for quite a few points. Nice dig from Justin Mattson. Jeremy Brown deflects off of the Yellow Jackets and out. Much needed point to break even with Randolph-Macon at 12. Nice feed from Cody Rogan. And there's a point for the Yellow Jackets. Wagenhauser and Rogan combining. couple of bodies were sprawled along the floor. So we'll get the dry mop out to take care of that. Tyler Schaefer on the duties. Cade Terrell on the serve for the Yellow Jackets. They're going to set up Sam Canlin inside. Another kill for Sam.
Sam Canlin with the kill.
Sam, get over now.
Knights looking for the next point to retake the lead. Off the top of the net for Bianchi. This is Cody Rogan. Deflecting off of Canlin and Evans. And falling just in front of Christo Bianchi. Randolph-Macon back up again, 14-13 now. Highly competitive third set here in Buena Vista. This is Wagenhauser. Tough receive there from Madsen. That's going to float out of bounds past the scorer's table. Jeremy Brown was looking to make a bid for it. Randolph making up by two. Tyler Evans just outside. Knights thinking about calling their timeout. I think they're going to let things go through, though. Says Wagenhauser. Outside. Good read from Christian Schaefer. It's 16-14. Randolph Macon looking to develop a comeback here in set three. That's Sam Canlin into the nets. Knights weren't happy with that one. You can see the reaction from Sam himself. This is Matthew Carroll. Tyler Schaefer setting up Kyler Evans. Big, strong kill. To counter. Jeremy Brown on the serve. Off the top of the net, good recovery from Van Esendelf. This is Rogan, straight down. Not often do you see one get straight through Kyler Evans and Christian Schaefer. But the Yellow Jackets have been finding those seams here in the third set. They extend their advantage back to three. This is Evans. He counters. But just looking for a bit more consistency here from Southern Virginia.
For the Knights, number eight, Jaren Brown.
They've been able to break even a few times, but have not been able to get over top of that mountain. This is Rogan feeding Wagenhauser, deflecting off of Bianchi. And another point back to Randolph-Macon as we go back and forth, of course, not doing the Knights any favors. Being down by 3 points now. They're going to have to put together a streak to come back in this set. This is Christian. Good dig that time from Randolph-Macon. Knights looking to counter with Tyler Schaefer. Nifty back over. Knights back within two.
By number 10, Tyler Schaefer, point Knights.
And don't be deceived by those two sets earlier today from Southern Virginia. Randolph making a very talented squad. Came into this season, I believe, nationally ranked in the preseason polls. So they are a formidable opponent. That'll be Christo Bianchi to knock that one back over. It also went off the ceiling. Knights within one. Looking to overcome Randolph Macon for a three-set sweep. But the Yellow Jackets threatening, 19-18, they lead as we head into this timeout from Randolph-Macon. 13 kills in set number three compared to 9 for Randolph-Macon. Quite a few of the Yellow Jackets' points have resulted from service errors of the Knights, as they are up to 5 on the sets. And in total, they have 15. In previous broadcasts, we've mentioned Knights' struggles with service errors. They've been able to counter that for the most part this season with a lot of service aces. But still certainly one thing that they want to clean up as we head into postseason play. Knights with 7 service aces on the day, but certainly not a 2-for-1 you want if you're Southern Virginia. This is Tyler Schaefer. Knights looking to get things tied back up. They trailed 19-16 not too long ago before that timeout. That's going to float past the line for Tyler. Nate gets 16 service errors on the day for the Knights.
Serving for the Yellow Jackets, number 9, Matteo DeLuca.
So Matteo DeLuca now. Off the top of the net, Cristo Bianchi able to dig it out. He's going to get this one back. Nice dig from Matteo DeLuca again. Up high, Madsen Brown is going to run for it. And he runs into the wall hard, but looks to be okay as he hopped over the coaches on that one. It looked like a pretty violent collision as he was full speed and didn't have any time to really break, put on the brakes, and coming back to the ground. This is Christian Schaefer. Putting the Knights back on the board. They trail by 2, 21-19. We've talked many times about that magic number of 20, 21, or 22. If you can get there first, that puts yourself in a really good spot to take the set. Knights going to try and counter. Good serve from Christian Schaefer, the ace for him. Knights back down by 1. Christian on the serve once again. Soars in, good dig from DeLuca to receive that one. Just outside, we are tied at 21. While the Knights haven't been challenged all too much this season, they were able to show their resiliency in a victory over Rutgers Newark in New Jersey not too long ago. They were down 2-1, came back to win the final 2 sets and clinch that one 3-2. That one just inside. Miscommunication between the two Schaefers, Tyler and Christian. Much needed point for Randolph-Macon. Christian on the attack. Off of Nick Futrell. Out of bounds, knotted back up at 22. We'll see Sam Callen come back in for Southern Virginia. The libero, Justin Madsen, will take a breather. Cristo Bianchi now getting us going. Nicely received from DeLuca. This is Wagenhauser, soars to the left out of bounds. A point for Southern Virginia, 23-22, 2 points away from clinching this one in a 3-set sweep, 1 from match points. That'll be a timeout from Randolph-Macon. As they've been able to live off of those Knight attacking errors as well as service errors here in the third set. The Knights have looked a little bit more dialed in here in the last few points. And that has put Randolph-Macon again in a deficit now. It's only 1. But Southern Virginia on the verge of finishing the regular season undefeated, a perfect 26-0, having already clinched the number one seed in the CVC, the rights to host the CVC tournament. And to put the cherry on top, a number one national ranking from the AVCA poll. They started the year already in the top 10 in the preseason poll and have slowly worked their way up to the top. Is this Krista Bianchi, 23-22 the score. Knights looking for a third set victory and another sweep of the Yellow Jackets. Good receive, miscommunication, one too many hits. That was Cody Rogan.
Knights on your feet for
and it is
points.
Match point for Southern Virginia. This is Bianchi. Good job by Plucker. Rejected! Yellow Jackets able to keep it alive. Good and composure to reset their attack. This is Wagenhauser. Good dig, Christian Schaefer. Back and forth we go. Jeremy Brown just outside. And the Yellow Jackets survive another points. Remember, it's win by two. So another point will force the Knights to reset an extra points. This is Sam Canlin off balance. Looking for the game, and that's Kyler Evans. Southern Virginia moves to 26-0 on the season with another defeat of Randolph-Macon to close out the regular season and bring the momentum into postseason play and the CVC tournament, which they will host next week. Of course, Randolph-Macon, we mentioned previously, will face off of Eastern Mennonites in the quarterfinals, hosted by Randolph-Macon on their home court in Ashland, Virginia. And then the winner of that quarterfinal one will face off against the number one seeded Southern Virginia University Knights. The winner of the 3-6 seed game, that's Marymount and Rutgers Newark, I believe, will face off against number two seeded Juniata. But this storybook season continues as the Knights are not only searching for, of course, this undefeated record, but they're searching for a CBC crown again, looking to reclaim it for the first time since 2021. And then, of course, looking to do some damage in the NCAA tournament that will be hosted not too long from now. But of course, we thank you all for joining us on this edition of Knights Broadcasting. We've loved broadcasting these men's volleyball events, and we will look forward to doing so for the CVC tournament, which will be hosted by Southern Virginia, I believe either at Rockbridge High School or at Washington and Lee, just as it did last year. But we thank you all for tuning in, and we give thanks as well to our stellar production crew here at Knights Broadcasting and all the great work that they do behind the scenes to present these athletic events to all of you tuning in at home or wherever you are. But again, thank you for tuning in. We look forward to seeing you soon. And go Knights!